In this video, I'll give you a tour of NC State's Quick Start course shell in Moodle. What is the Quick Start course shell? Well, it's a framework into which you can build or organize a course. It's designed to promote consistency in online course design by providing guidance based on best practices for quality online education. The Quick Start course shell design maximizes usability, readability, navigation, and accessibility. I have the Quick Start course shell open, and I'm in the course as an instructor, with edit mode turned off in the upper right corner. For now, I'm going to close the course index and the block drawer so we can focus on the center area of the page. The layout of the Quick Start course shell is set to show one section per page. This means that the main page of the course shows the title of all the sections, but only the first section shows the items that are actually within it. If you'd like to change the course layout to show all sections in a collapsible format on one page, you can do this by going to Settings in the course menu, locate the course format setting, and then select Show All Sections on One Page, and save. The sections in the Quick Start course shell include a course resources section, a Start Here section, a sample module, and an instructor sandbox, which is hidden from students. The instructor sandbox is simply a place for you to work and plan directly in your Moodle course, but to do it in a place where students won't be able to see any of the items, unless you move them into a visible section. Let's tour each section in detail, starting at the top of the course. Course resources is a place to put items you'd like students to find easily throughout the duration of the course. The first two items in the course resources are for instructor reference only. Once you finish with them, you can choose to delete them if you like, but they're not visible to students. First, you'll find a page of instructions for using the Quick Start course shell, including a link to this video and the user guide for the shell. Next is a page of suggested items to add to your course resources section. We'll come back to that in a second. Next is the announcements forum for instructors to send updates and notifications to all students enrolled in the course. Remember, these announcements are also delivered to all course participants via email. It's a one-way forum that only instructors can post to. The student help forum is a place where students and the instructor can discuss student questions about the course. Let's look at the instructor reference page for some other items you can add to the course resources section. We recommend including your syllabus in the course resources, perhaps as a URL link to a Google Doc or as a file resource. We've provided a link to NC State's syllabus template, which is another tool that can provide consistency for students across courses. This template contains all the components required by NC State's syllabus regulation, as well as other items informed by best practices. We also recommend including your course map, if you have one, as a URL resource or file. We've provided links to a course map template, as well as some links to learn more about how course maps can provide transparency in your course design. You might also want to include links to regularly accessed online reference materials specific to your course. If you have a lot of these, you can consolidate them in a Moodle page if they're links, or into a folder if they're files. This helps to keep the course resources section from becoming too long. The next course section in the Quick Start course shell is the Start Here section. Start Here is unmistakably the place where students should get started, which helps them to know what to do the first time they access the course. This section welcomes your students and sets the tone for your course from the start. And it gives students important information about the expectations, structure, and flow of the course that they should know from the beginning. Within Start Here, there are two subsections grouped under headings. In the overview, you'll find some sample text that you can modify. We recommend providing a summary here to explain to students the purpose of this section and what they will find here. Next, we recommend giving students a task list. We've listed two suggested items to the task list already. Students new to Moodle can complete the online and distance education virtual orientation and or the Learning with Moodle tutorial, and reading the syllabus, which they'll find in the course resources section. You'll likely have other tasks for students to do to get started in your course, so go ahead and list them here. Remember to edit and customize all of this example text before your course goes live. In the Start Here resources and activities, you'll find a page, once again, hidden from students, that lists items you might consider adding to Start Here in your course. We've included the rationale for the Start Here section and a copy of the sample text. Scrolling down, you'll find suggested resources and activities. The importance of these items can somewhat depend on the format of your course. If your course is fully online, we highly recommend a welcome video and a guided tour of the Moodle site. You'll find some information about each of these, as well as links to examples. Regardless of format, a course overview and a copy of a welcome letter that you send out to students are helpful to include. And you'll find templates for both. Last, you'll find the recommendation that you include an introduce yourself forum, where students can start getting to know one another and building a learning community. We've included an introduce yourself forum here for your convenience. Be sure to edit any text and requirements for this forum to suit your own purposes. Next, we have a sample module. You can use this sample as a guide and modify it as needed into what fits your course best. Then you can duplicate it as many times as you need, depending on the number of units or modules in your course. Let's start with the module title. We've suggested a consistent format for module titles that will ease navigation through the course. The module title includes a number for the module, a concise descriptive title, and the dates for the module. For guidance on using the customizable template, see this page for instructors, which is not visible to students. As you view this module as a whole, notice the subsection headers. Properly formatted headers make the page more easily readable and lend an organizational structure to the module. The overview of each module is meant to give students a sense of what to expect in that unit of the course. You might offer a summary, introductory text, or an introductory video, and share the learning objectives for that module. Sharing learning objectives helps students understand the purpose of the module content and gives them a sense of how they will be assessed. A student task list will communicate clearly what students need to do to complete the module successfully. Next, we have some possible other subsections inside this module. The sample module provides one possible organizational scheme that reflects best practices in asynchronous online courses. We encourage you to modify this structure as needed to fit your own course. Regardless of how you organize your course, be sure to provide guidance for how to use the materials or complete the activities for each subsection. Organize your learning materials, learning activities, and assessments in a way that reflects your recommendations for how students should proceed through the module. You can use this structure or change and adapt it to fit how you recommend students interact with your course material. If you want to change the title of any of these subheadings, simply turn Editing on. Go to Edit Settings in the three-dot menu to the right of the Text and Media area, and modify the text. You want to make sure to modify both the title of the Text and Media area, which is what shows up in the course index, and also the text that is displayed on the main course page. To add additional module subsections, you can go to the three-dot menu and select Duplicate, and then edit the name and text of the copied heading, as described before. Again, once you've decided on an organizational structure that works for your course, stick as much as possible with that structure from module to module. This helps students to focus on learning and not on figuring out where to find things week to week. Once you have your first module organized how you like it, you can duplicate it. Just go to the three-dot menu to the right of the course section name, and then select Duplicate. You can do this as many times as you need for your course. Let's take a quick look at the course index. I'm now viewing this course as a student. The titles of text and media areas do appear in the course index for students. So in the Start Here section, the overview is a text and media area. In the course index, we see Start Here Overview as the title of the text and media area under the section title. As long as all the sections in the Moodle course are open, I can navigate not only to activities, but also to these text and media areas and subsections of the course. And any activities or resources I have indented on the main page are also indented in the course index. And this helps make the structure and hierarchy of your course clear. Now let's take a look at what's included in the blocks of the Quick Start course shell. So I'm back in the role of instructor now. The Meet Your Instructor block is a text area that is fully editable. Include this block to put your contact information front and center, and include a picture to humanize your course. To modify this block, turn Edit Mode on, click on the three dots at the top right of the block, and choose Configure Meet Your Instructor block. The next block provides links to the virtual orientation for online and distance education and to the Learning with Moodle tutorial. This is to help students who are new to NC State or new to Moodle. Remember, we've also suggested that you include these resources as an optional activity in the Start Here section. You can choose to include this information in one or both places. The Student Services block is pre-populated for you and cannot be edited. It offers quick links for students to access important campus resources. The Activities block provides a quick way for you and your students to view all activities of a certain type on one page. For example, a student can view all the quizzes for the course, all the forums, etc. The Quick Start course shell only has forums and resources, so currently that's all that's being shown in the Activities block. But when you add more activity types to your course, they will appear here. Last, the Instructor Resources and Support block is not visible to students and is not editable. It's a place for you to quickly access support and resources for teaching in Moodle. This concludes your tour of the Quick Start course shell. If you want to use the Quick Start course shell, in Wolfware, go to the Moodle settings, and then scroll to the bottom of the page and select the Quick Start course shell as your source when you create your new Moodle space. More guidance is available in the user guide, which is linked below the video and found at go.ncsu.edu/moodle-course-shell.